Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am doing another paint pen tutorial. This one is going to be some strawberries. These paint pens are great for rocks, glass, ceramic, plastic, and more. So anything you want to paint on, really. Today I'm using a dark gray rock. You do need a piece of paper to start them off with. You got to shake them vigorously, press them down, make the ink come to the tip. And then you're off to the races. Now, just showing you here, you don't want to use the finer paint pens for filling in color like I just did with the strawberry. I wanted to show you the difference between the fine lining and the thicker paint brushes. I believe they're 5 millimeter, or paint pens, sorry. They are 5 millimeter, and they fill in and cover the color like a lot better. So I'll show you here. I'm using the 5 millimeter. You shake it vigorously. You press it down on the paper until the acrylic paint starts to bleed to the end of your tip. And then look at the coverage, like compared to the fine lining paint pen. You don't want to use the fine lining to fill in color. You just want to use it for lining or for very small details. These bigger ones, however, are full coverage. You probably only need maybe 2 coats if you're working on a darker surface like I am. But look at how bold this green is on top of this dark gray rock. Like, it's just so bright and smooth. It's not skipping and jumping over my rock, but my rock is fairly smooth. So keep in mind, if you're using a rough surface, you might have some skipping and jumping happening, possibly some splatter from the paint pens. So go slowly, or you can also smooth your rock by resining it first, seal it, smooth the surface as much as you can before you start painting on it, or else the paint pens might be a little bit frustrating and you might give up, like I did previously with a different paint pen brand. I was just upset with it once I was done because it made a mess everywhere. But you have to be careful with the surface that you're painting on, so keep that in mind. Luckily, this one is fairly smooth and I've had no issues with any mess. Now, they do offer oil-based paint pens as well, but I am just using the acrylic-based paint pens today. They have fine lining ones in all different colors, including silver and gold, black and white, all colors. I'm just adding a little bit of like a cream color and I'm dabbing it with my finger because I want to lighten that portion of the strawberry up a little bit. And blending is very different when it comes to using paint pens. It's difficult, but I'm a blender, so I still try. But I will be adding a little white shine to the strawberries very soon. I always recommend letting everything dry before you try and paint up over it again. It will make a mess if you don't wait for it to dry. So patience is actually very important with paint pens. I'm going to use the fine lining, I call it fine lining paint pen, because I'm so used to saying fine lining paintbrush. But the finer tip paint pens are what I'm going to use to outline. You can clean it up once the black paint is dry. You can make those black lines thinner, less noticeable. You can go in with the red or the green and thin out all those lines, and it covers very well. You don't even see the black paint. So if you've seen me in my videos, I do a bit of cleanup. I also can do that with paint pens as long as it's extra dry. So I keep my hairdryer on a cool setting, keep it directly beside my desk here. And when I'm impatient waiting for those layers to dry, I get my hairdryer. So I've put a little bit of white just to give it a little bit of shine, but then I'm going to do the black seed spots all over and cover those up as well. Now, like I said, the fine lining is great for just kind of lining things out before you fill it in with color. But I'm showing you how dark it is with the fine lining, fine tip, and then I'm going to fill it in with the bigger tip, and it just gives it so much, like a full layer of color. So I'm using the fine tip for the seed spots on the strawberries as well. And I went right over top of that white like it wasn't even there. Just pretend it's not there. Now I'm doing little white flowers. I do, because it's white and I have such a dark rock, I'm going to do a couple of coats. I'm going to let it dry in between and do a couple of coats on the petals, because I want them to make sure they don't turn gray after drying. So you want to have a couple coats there. I will outline those as well with a fine tip, but not until they're dry. So I'm going in with the green and filling in those little bits that come out the top of the strawberry, making sure that they're nice and bold. I'm doing a little bit of cleanup in my leaves, thinning out some of the black lines, and making sure that everything looks the way I want it to. I apologize for part of the rock being off the screen. This is what I get for doing tutorials while I'm on vacation. I just kind of make do with the lighting and make do with the space. And I'm doing the best I can now with the narration of it all afterwards. So I hope you guys aren't too disappointed. I thought these strawberries would be kind of fun. They're kind of like a vintage strawberry tattoo type of thing. So I thought you guys would like it. I just want to thank all of my loyal subscribers. I love you all. Thank you for being so supportive. You're just amazing, each and every one of you. And I wanted to switch things up a little bit, let you hear my singing voice, and try out some paint pens. What else can we do? There's also an owl tutorial for paint pens. Give it a try. I've outlined my flowers with the fine tip with the black. Pause it so you can see what I've done, because this. Sorry that I cut myself off there, guys. I'm still not good at this editing thing, but I thought I'd give you a little bit more video at the end so that you could take a look at it and get a better view. But thank you guys for all your patience and understanding when it comes to these terribly edited videos. I love you. Bye.